Greetings, my esteemed Laddingtons. I will sound like a complete normaling now, but I am excited. Excited indeed to share this fine game with you. I have waited a long time for this, and as I will elaborate on further as we get into the game, this game, Age of Empires 2, has been a huge influence of mine. And I will credit my history interest to this game. Played it a lot with my brother back in the day. So we're just gonna have a look through the campaigns and the historical battles, and then we'll pick a campaign and get into it, and I will talk more about the influence it had on me. So yeah, as I said, I had a quick look at it by myself yesterday, and it looked absolutely amazing. The remastered, the music as well, absolutely glorious in the correct sense of the word. So let's look at historical battles first. So we have a lot of epicness here. I shared this on Telegram and Twitter yesterday because I was, and Instagram of course, because I was so excited. Not often I get excited by a game like this, but since it's been with me for such a long time, I am, very excited. So we have York Vinland Saga. I remember that one. Hastings, I do not remember being part of the first game when it came out. Agincourt, though, I mentioned this in a recent Swedish history video when I talked about knights. Then Tours, of course, which I've talked a lot about in also various history videos. Then we have Lepanto, glorious battle. So anyway, we have a lot of cool things here to dive into later on. So I do believe that Assassin's Creed will be on hold for a little bit because we have so much historical juiciness to get into here. So my thought was to get into some sort of campaign, and this is the good stuff, of course, because it's Europe, but I will just show you the other campaigns also really quickly. So we have Montezuma. Loved that campaign when I played it back in the day. Loved playing as the Aztecs. Then we have a new, for me at least, because I didn't play Forgotten Kingdoms. I only played the Age of Conquerors. So the Incas can be interesting to play as well. Then we have a lot of interesting stuff here. And the great thing with this game is that for me, I've learned so much history from it, and you can still learn so much from it. So I have honestly no real idea who any of these are. And it will be nice to get into them at some point. Genghis Khan, classic campaign. I loved playing that back in the day too. Tamerlane, I have actually read a book on the Mughal invasion, and then they discuss who was the greatest, Tamerlane or Genghis Khan. So the descendants of them, when they invade India, they discuss who was the greatest of those two. So Tamerlane, fascinating story as well. Might make a campaign at some point. We have Africa. Saladin, great campaign. Obviously you are playing for the wrong side, but Saladin was a man of honor, so we have to respect that. Then we have some other campaigns, which I don't know anything about either. Then we have Francisco de Almeida of glorious Portugal. Might be nice to look into as well. Now, back to the main thing here. I have played, of course, back in the day, Attila. I've talked about this on numerous occasions, both in text, in my book, and in videos, and in articles, etc. The sheer epicness, sheer epic sensation of being in the late stages of the Roman Empire, and of course Attila, the legend of Attila. As you can see here, Scourge of God. It's an epic thing to think about, especially in the situation we are in Western Europe today. Quite similar to Western Europe in that time. But I will save that for another time. We have Alaric, epic name. And I have made Let's Play episodes in Attila Total War as well, on both the Romans itself, themselves and the Ostrogoths and yeah, some Let's Plays there. So that is one option, of course, for us to make a Let's Play. El Cid, highly motivating story. I talked about it briefly in my Spanish Reconquista video I released 2 months back. William Wallace, this is a learning campaign, so this wasn't really all too intriguing, but yeah, I played that back in the day as well. Joan of Arc, also an epic campaign I played back in the day. Same thing with Barbarossa. So yeah, a lot of cool things to choose from. What I will choose, though, what I think is most reasonable, is to play Dracula, because I haven't played this campaign, because this is, yeah, as I said, I only played up until the Age of Conquerors, then I didn't really play the expansions, but now, when they released everything, I'm very excited, indeed, to get into it. So, without further ado, let's get into Valachia. The dragon spreads his wings. So let's get into it. Boom.
We could not make camp in the damp forest glade, so I led my companions along an old path towards the base of the mountain. It was overgrown with all manner of foliage, and the footing was difficult. Armor and weapons littered the path, and stakes stood tall, covered with vines and moss. Glancing around, I spotted a magnificent blade. Light yet firm and unblemished by the elements, it shone in the rain and lightning, a lone light in the darkening trail. The hilt was fashioned from steel, inlaid with silver and gold to form the figure of a defiant, wingless dragon. As we reached the summit, I could not believe my eyes. A ruined yet imposing castle loomed above us. Quietly rejoicing, my comrades moved towards their new camp. Then we heard the howls. The massive wolves bounded out of the door of the castle towards my soldiers. Fearing for their lives, they drew weapons, only to hear a voice from the shadows address the wolves or the men. Valachian accent. Stand down, fellows. Throwing large slabs of meat to the ravenous wolves, he calmed them and satiated their hunger. Then he turned to us. Welcome to Polinari Castle, the ancient stronghold of the Draculesti. The mysterious man raised his hands in a gesture. It is well that your path has led you here. Come inside, sit by the fire, and feast, while I tell you the tale of Vlad Dracula.
Epic introduction. Okay, so we're in the game. Main objectives. Vlad Dracula must survive. We'll look at the hints too. And a note on that introduction, when I played it back in the day, I always found those introductions so absolutely motivating. So yeah, good times. Anyway, let's get back to the hints. Valachia is a dense and mountainous region. Use your ranged units well and beware of those of your enemies. The local Vovoids and their troops are a means to an end. Be frugal, but do not despair if some fall in battle. Keep an eye out for Valachian partisans that are willing to join your army. Demolition ships are deadly to anything too close to the shoreline. Deleting them when they are adjacent to a target accomplishes the same effect as a direct hit. The explosions of the Danesti gunpowder tower will destroy the bridge and anything on it. Do not lose men needlessly. On standard difficulty, a monk will accompany your force. Yes, I actually did play on standard because I didn't want to come across... I didn't want to lose in this fine episode. So, we have some scout reports here as well. Dracula, in red, has arrived in Valachia at the head of a small Ottoman force. These men will serve to guard him initially, but more men must be recruited if Valachia is to be taken. Three local Vovoids rule the southern half of the map. Should Dracula prove his mettle, they may swear fealty to him. And some other things. The designs of Hungary are unknown, but it is no friend of Dracula's Turkish patrons.
My lord, the landscape around us is crawling with Danishti scum, but three local voivodes resist Vladislav's reign. We should seek them out and see if they are willing to join our cause.
All right, let's do it. And as you can see, the game looks absolutely amazing. The graphics and just the feel of it. So, yeah, I'm very impressed. I am impressed by your performance. That's my Georges St-Pierre imitation. But yeah, to anyone who has been part of making this game, well done. We have a monk here. I will try to convert something fun with it. Did we actually get someone? No. Our soldiers killed them before we could get a chance. I can heal someone though. Can you heal this guy? Vovoid Mirkia. Okay. Aha, it's an ally. How nice. Slavic true friend. And up here we have Voivod Jakub. Good stuff, good stuff. So yeah, as you can see, the graphics are very much improved. Actually, it looks better than Age of Empires 3, I would say, which had amazing graphics. Hello, lads. We have come to...
Dracula, your timing could not have been better. Vladislav's forces march here as we speak. Take my men and drive them off.
Right, who are the... Aha, they're up here.
Forward, men. Bring me Mircha's head.
I think I might have set the difficulty level to a bit too low, because this might seem a bit easy. I don't know. We'll see how this develops. I'm gonna try to convert this boyar. He looks great. Oh, right. I am a bit noobish now because I rushed in with my cavalry. I'm not supposed to, of course, rush in with cavalry into pikemen like that. But, oh well. I haven't played in a while. I have to blame that. So, as I was saying, my brother and I, and our friends, back in the day when we were like 12 until 14, 15,
I will
played.
Follow you to the abyss and back.
Okay, thank you, mate. Yeah, we played a lot. Played a lot of LAN. Yeah, much on Highland, Black Forest. Is teaming up with each other and fighting against... the computers. It was good times, and really got that sense of epicness in it all. Now I want to convert something fun with this monk bra. Maybe I can reach this boyar and convert him. Ah, they were. I managed to do it. Now I have a boyar to play with. So, yes, have to go up there and see what is up. And as I mentioned in the beginning of the video, they have remastered the music. And actually, when I've written on my book Dauntless and also on my book, my coming book, I sometimes put the soundtrack of Age of Empires 2 on to get that epic sensation. Music is really good, especially for Age of Kings, the first game.
That rascal Vladislav have seized the nearby settlement and cut us off from our trade.
that rascal Vladislav.
I will reward you handsomely.
Okay, let's do it. Aha, we got a battering ram as well. See if we can... They're speaking Turkish. How blasphemous. Oh well, it is what it is. We have to make the best out of the situation. So anyway, speaking of Hungary and Romania, I don't know what has happened, but every time I mention anything related to Romania, there is always some Hungarians who are mightily upset. Aha, look at that. We actually managed to convert the boyar, and then it got he got shot to death anyway. Admire this aesthetic waterfall. Hello, lads. So, yeah, if you're Hungarian, it's not a good look. It's just annoying, and especially for Americans and Western Europeans, we're not really overly concerned with your centuries-old conflicts. So, yeah, no one cares. That being said, I will try to convert this guy. I don't want my monk to die, though. Oh, back. This is the guy we need to convert. Nah, he didn't make it. A shame. So anyway, I've gotten some questions. My favorite civilization in Age of Empires 2.
Bless you. This man will do your bidding, and this gold will finance your war.
Perfect. Always nice with gold. Something you always need if you are to engage in some sort of war. Anyway, as I was saying, I actually posted on Instagram in the spring when I was in Holland. We had a good few activities. One of those was throwing axes. And then I posted to Instagram that a Frankish throwing axeman is checking in. And I asked what everyone's favorite faction and such is. And I responded that my own might be either the Teutons or the Britons. But I'm not sure. Might be the Goths as well. A lot of cool civilizations. And the interesting thing here now for me is that since I haven't played so many of these new factions, it's, yeah, I'm like a child on Christmas. So many new packages to open. So, yeah. Good times. And here we have Vlad Dracula. Very aesthetic unit. An absolute unit, one might say. And now I suppose we have to recruit one more Vovoid, and he is up here. So we'll just cross the map. I will explore a bit with this mad cunt. Aha! Some local partisans. Our scouting was a good idea. So anyway, I have contracted an artist with a heart on the right place to make a cool Vlad Dracula design that I will use for Legio Gloria clothing. So yeah, stay tuned for that. Speaking of which, we have some new absolutely epic garments coming out later today or tomorrow. The greatest garment, I've called it, but I will elaborate more on that in a video log of sorts. Now I will try to shoot these guys from far. And try to convert this guy. No. Our soldiers, they're too quick at killing the enemy. Oh, look at that. Aha, we have a wolf on our tails. We need to... I'm sorry for the wildlife, but had to do it to save my men. Sacks are quite infected.
Vladiso pillages my lands with impunity, Dracula. Even now, more of his reavers prepare to cross the nearby bridge. Find a way to destroy it, and all of the men that I can muster are yours.
Yeah, as I was saying, there's a...
Lord Dracula, we banished the fool, store a cache of gunpowder inside that tower overlooking the river. If we were to fire it, the explosion would surely be enough to demolish that bridge.
I must do it. Now, as I was saying, a frequent occurrence that I get interrupted when I make Let's Plays, but it's all good. What I was saying is that there is a rather infected conflict in Sweden when it comes to wolf hunting, where the people on the countryside who are getting, well, their pets and livestock get attacked by wolves. They are not all too keen on the wolves, but the people in the cities are more protective of them. So yeah, that's well, somewhat hot topic in Sweden. Now, of course, we have bigger problems in Sweden these days, but it's still there, that little conflict. Okay, so now we'll blow this bridge up. Boom.
Aha, the sweet smell of burning gunpowder. Oh, you are a man worthy of my loyalty, Dracula.
The wolf is cornered, but not yet dead. It is time to take the fight to his den.
Alright, let's do it. We need to... Okay, we have to go back to that place. And now we have quite a sizable force here. But we're playing as the Turks. I don't understand. This is... it's not reasonable in the least. Speaking of Turks, my friend Survive the Jive made a good documentary video called In Search of the Anatolian Earth Mother, or something like that. So yeah, in the documentary he goes to Turkey and looks at some old Lycian ruins and temples, etc. I utilized a little edit there. And now we have to admire the grand procession of soldiers crossing this bridge here. So anyway, Dracula, for those of you who do not know about Vlad Tepes, great European hero, someone we can draw inspiration from in these dire times. So that's why I decided to make this campaign first. And of course, since I haven't played this actual campaign, so it's, yeah, as I said, some new Christmas presents for me to open, so to speak. Oh, damn, we have stumbled upon the Danesti forces here. But they proved to be no problem. Aha, we have gotten some fresh troops here. Such a beautiful map. We have Ibex here. Let's see if we can convert this pikeman. No. He managed to die before. So anyway, comment below in the comment section, if you watched this far, what your favorite civilization is. It's always nice to hear. Actually, I was going to say something as well about Age of Empires 2. I have a good analysis, well, in my humble opinion at least, it's good, on why the Age of Empires 2 community is so much friendlier than a lot of other online gaming communities. And it's... I am born in 89, by the way, so I'm 30 now. Back in our... in our day, as it were, it wasn't as easy to get games, to find games. So, yeah, it wasn't as easy to find other people to play with, and when you did, you viewed each other as friends in a different way than you perhaps do today. And also since, yeah, it was a different time on the internet, I think people were a bit friendlier, especially in the gaming community, back then at least. Whereas people are a bit unfriendlier now, I suppose. That being said, let us illuminate these heretics. Where have our monk disappeared? I want to convert something fun with him. And we need to keep Dracula back, I suppose, so he doesn't die. That would be quite unfortunate so close to the end of this campaign. I'm perhaps not micromanaging as well as I should, but it is what it is. We have to defend our battering ram at least. I actually thought about live streaming this, but I am.
Vladislav to me.
I want him alive. Yeah, no, in regard to live streaming.
A large Hungarian army approaches from the north, with Vladislav at its head.
Curses! We cannot hope to face such a force. I will seek refuge with my cousin Bogdan in Moldavia.
You are victorious. Okay, cool. Yes.
I stepped forth, holding out the mysterious sword and scabbard for our host to inspect.
The Order of the Dragon, she said at once. What you have just brought me is the lost blade of Vlad Dracula himself. I was shocked and immediately demanded an explanation. Our host's eyes flashed and there was a strained look on his face. Finally, the rush of memory seemed to slow and become more controlled. That is a long story. But then again, we have a long time until dawn. Dracula sought refuge at the Moldavian court. There, he learned that Vladislav II had begun to mediate peace talks between the Ottomans and Hungarians, securing his position as Voivode of Valachia. Furious, Dracula swore vengeance on Ottomans, Valachian boyars, and Danish the clansmen alike.
As is reasonable. So, yes, now, as I was going to say, I prefer making Let's Plays because then you can watch it whenever and you don't need to book in a special time, even though it's fun with the interaction and all, but yeah, I do prefer just making a video and then uploading it to YouTube. So, next episode, I suppose, we'll go to Return of the Dragon. Good times, good times. So, thank you all for watching and have a great rest of your day. XOXO, boom.